Hello, and welcome to Ag4Life Oklahoma Strong, new FCS programming developed to help our audiences stay strong, physically active, and socially connected, all essential for aging well. Here we focus on a core mission of Ag4Life, and that's arthritis management for today's aging families. Learning to control arthritis pain and stiffness is key to health and well-being, and it's the basis for this Ag4Life Arthritis Management Programming, heretofore called AAMP or AMP, like Amp It Up. I'm Jan Johnston, your Adulthood and Aging Specialist, and I invite you to learn how to gear up your audiences living with arthritis to improve in four issue team areas: health, safety, job readiness, and resilience. If we want to be in the business of helping Oklahomans age well, we must amp up both the quantity and the quality of moving. Yes, just moving. Getting strong means staying strong, and we know keeping an active body, mind, and spirit is the best remedy for a society that has generally gone soft from inactivity, for many due to pain and stiffness of arthritis. Amp It Up aims to help audiences of all ages get strong, stay active, and be empowered to take control of their arthritis. In this program, we focus on two management areas to help audiences control their pain and stiffness. Number one, consistently attending exercise classes. Three program opportunities we'll talk about later. We aspire to do what the lady is doing in the photo. We don't start at that level necessarily, but with consistent and appropriate exercise, we can reach that level. Number two, exploring AT resource possibilities with hands-on demonstrations, catalogs to peruse, and referrals to Oklahoma AbleTech for expert information. From the photo here of the gardening set, it's been designed for less strain and more digging force. We aim to help folks find, use, and enjoy appropriate assistive technology, known as AT henceforth. Used together, regular exercise and appropriate AT reduce the likelihood of a fall. They improve the person's activity level, with many added benefits of positive mood, mind, and spirit. Arthritis management is more than having a strong body. It's also about having a strong brain and mind, for communicating with others, making decisions, all with a sense of independence about personal choices and interdependence in family relationships. It's about a strong sense of safety every time, not willing to take chances. We know falls often happen when we take shortcuts, or that safety is for older people. A strong set of coping skills is necessary. When we're in control of our lives, we are better able to cope with the expected and the unexpected changes in families, work, and friends. And arthritis management is also about a strong circle of social support. The giving and receiving of help, assistance, a listening ear, all mean we are plugged in. We enjoy a multi-generational interdependence. Let that term sink in. Multi-generational interdependence, when all generations work together to enjoy that circle of support. As we help folks manage arthritis with exercise and AT, we bring it back to four issue team goals with outcomes for healthy aging. We have short-term and long-term objectives with this programming. We want folks to immediately start physical activity programs by joining our Amp It Up program with the potential to do three different classes. Teaching audiences to follow best safety practices every time is critical, as is staying in control of arthritis pain to stay job ready, life ready. And we want folks to consider using appropriate AT around the home, in the garden, or community to safely and efficiently go about their daily lives. Incorporating exercise and AT, they immediately reduce the likelihood of falls and accidents, for example. And in all of these ways, we're building skills of resilience, personal resilience, family resilience, and community resilience. Our long-range impact will be audience commitment to maintaining good health with strength building and physical activity a core part of that. I want to acknowledge the generous contributions of those who make Ag4Life Oklahoma Strong and our arthritis management program Amp It Up possible. I'm referring to FCS Ambassador's Dorothy Blackwell Legacy Award and Oklahoma AgriBility, funded by USDA NIFA for a successful 12-year run at OSU. Educator Arthritis Leader Certification is made possible by the generous funding of the Blackwell Legacy Award. Without this assistance, we would not be able to do this statewide, thus increase our impact greatly. So we owe great appreciation for the opportunity to use this award to help Oklahomans better manage their arthritis with Arthritis Foundation's Exercise Program, AFEP, and Walk with Ease. You'll hear more about them later. Over its 12-year run at OSU, Oklahoma AgriBility was all about helping farm and ranch families stay productive on the job despite living with injuries, conditions, and disability. Staying strong, physically active, and socially connected was made possible by helping farmers and ranchers and their families acquire and use appropriate AT resources so they could remain employed, active, and productive. Now with Ag4Life, we aim to continue that with lessons on back health, vision and hearing precautions, arthritis management, and assistive technology that encourages audiences to find, use, and enjoy exercise and AT resources. Safety, efficiency, ease, and confidence in everyday task and movement is our mission. Arthritis. You know the term if you've lived with some with it or you've developed it yourself. 50 million Americans live with some form of it. Those with osteoarthritis, the most common form, comprise 18% of women and 10% of men worldwide. This is according to the World Health Organization. Pain that comes with arthritis leads to inactivity and weakness. Our natural instinct is to stop that which hurts us, so we often sit. But sitting is not good for our arthritis, and we want to help audiences learn to move again. Moving again and exercising may mean some muscle soreness after activities in the beginning, but the long-range benefits of consistent and dedication will pay off. Research shows us that exercise is the best treatment by far for osteoarthritis. In effect, the exercise, the movement, the strength building is a natural painkiller. When we say arthritis pain and stiffness, what we really mean is joint pain and stiffness. The disease damages in around joints that the body can't fully repair. In a healthy joint, as we see here, there's cartilage on the end of our bones there to protect and buffer with synovial fluid that runs in the area between the bones. When the cartilage thins out and the synovial fluid becomes inflamed, we experience pain. So arthritis pain has another component, weak muscles, and this is the focus of our programming. Having strong muscles takes the weight off the joints. It unloads them, preventing stress and strain that leads to pain and stiffness. Building and keeping strong muscles is our goal. As we've learned, living with arthritis becomes an issue for most of us over our lifetime. The prevalence and the impact of this condition demands and deserves proven ways to manage it. The rate of arthritis, roughly 50 million Americans have some form of it, with over 820,000 Oklahomans impacted, means it can't be ignored. Knowing that movement is the best medicine for arthritis, we aim to bring evidence-based exercise programs into our communities to improve health, mood, and quality of life. Specifically, we aim to move to strengthen muscles to help support the joints. Weak muscles cause arthritis pain, as we've learned. We want to reacquaint our audiences with the notion of moving and how if we're not moving, we're not in our personal best shape, able to control arthritis pain. FCS has a unique advantage in making a difference in arthritis management. We want to put Oklahomans in charge of their pain and stiffness instead of the other way around. Too often, pain and stiffness means less and less activity and mobility with greater incidence of cardiovascular disease, depression, and anxiety. On the road to arthritis management, there may be obstacles. It's just what happens when people take a fall. Falls occur for any number of reasons, and sobering news is falls are preventable. Taking a fall can start a cascade of decline in persons of all ages. A fall happens in a heartbeat and is never planned. It just happens, but not to me, and then it does. Falls happen to all of us. It takes just one slip. Falls have life-changing consequences and often come when we attempt to shortcut safety steps in climbing, walking, and reaching, for example. Here listed, we see things to consider to prevent falls, including a strong core to keep us upright with good muscle tone, sensible shoes, multi-lighting of areas and homes and yards, and using appropriate assistive technology. Certainly following safety practices is essential to staying fall-free. We also know that weakness and inactivity increase fall and accident risk. Further, waiting until after we've had an accident to consider AT resources means missing out on how using it now protects us. We'll talk more about AT in a bit. My personal best shape. So what does that mean to you? Chances are it means being in your own personal range on various factors like weight or stamina or coping ability. Many of us live outside our preferred range, maybe never satisfied with our energy levels, our blood pressure readings, or our general health status, thinking we could do better. The word personal is used to offset some of the more competitive feeling of the word best. This is about what is best for your shape. Physically, that's internal and external. Mentally, what's your best shape emotionally, spiritually, and socially? Amp It Up is a program that helps us stay in our personal best shape by keeping core strong. Our core is at the middle of our being, our warehouse of strength where our back, trunk, neck connect with hips, arms, shoulders, legs, and feet. We want our audiences to get back in touch with this powerhouse in the center of the body, from the upper chest down through the abdomen, upper and lower, around to the lower, middle, and upper back. We want to build a strong core for foundation. We want folks to stay vigilant about their endurance. Can I finish my chores? And what about my muscular strength? Can I lift or grasp any number of objects to my satisfaction? And walking comfort. How likely am I to purposefully park a distance from my building? And keeping a circle of social support. Do I give and receive support from others freely? Am I plugged into my community through family, friends, church, and neighbors? Amp It Up is our tagline. We target arthritis, a health condition affecting millions of people from all walks of life in all cultures and races. When we amp up our activity, we begin to take control of pain and stiffness. And that's a huge difference in that most people are controlled by their arthritis. We seek to reverse that. Building on our own agricultural heritage, we teach audiences to effectively manage the pain and stiffness of daily life so they can continue to do what they love. We want to teach that moving is essential, but moving in targeted and practiced ways of organized group exercise. Take a look at these photos. We see people doing fall prevention exercises. Amp It Up provides walking groups, light strength exercising, and balance programs that all promote fall prevention. Walking has been shown again and again to be probably the safest, most effective form of exercise we can do. It comes naturally, it costs nothing, and you only need a good pair of shoes to get started to better cardiovascular health. Doing strength training for core muscles helps us to stay balanced, centered, and in control of our movements. We can use light hand weights or the weight of our own resistance to do a variety of exercises to build muscle and tighten core. Let's look at how these three programs, walking, strength training, and balance, might enhance your FCS programming. I encourage you to provide arthritis management classes in your community. Our exercise program helps folks to strengthen their bodies while increasing physical activity and flexibility over the long haul. This means they'll have better sleep, better weight management, better range of motion, easier movement. And yes, they will learn how not to fall. In all exercising, the importance of gentle stretching cannot be overstated either. Let's take the time before and after activities to nurture the body. Now let's look at a variety of exercise classes for teacher certification available to you. Amp It Up is an umbrella for three exercise programs that target arthritis management. They are Arthritis Foundation Exercise Program, AFEP, or AFEP. This program was previously known as land-based exercise and uses light strength training. Walk With Ease is an Arthritis Foundation signature program that builds endurance and social support. Tai Chi, Moving for Better Balance, is offered through Oklahoma Department of Health at no charge and is backed by scientific results that improve many areas of daily life. As we look at each program in detail, determine how you can start helping your audiences manage their arthritis. AFEP continues to be a group-based exercise class where you learn ways to manage your arthritis while also participating in a supportive group setting. It works because folks commit to return to class. Everyone works at their own pace, doing light strength training, balance, and endurance building. Standing and sitting exercises are used. Note, if you went through training with Rosemary in 2013-2014, you must go through the new and improved online training to continue. You'll find updated materials and less paperwork. Now you simply register the site where you will be holding your classes. No more site agreements signed by both parties. And this is just one change. Arthritis Foundation no longer trains, so they've outsourced AFEP to another organization, Aquatic Exercise Association. That's AEA. We'll talk about them in just a bit. They chose AEA as a nonprofit training organization because they have a mission to provide the best education for fitness, health, and wellness worldwide. AFEP is taught along with their aquatic programming certification. And FCS is simply just taking one half of that certification. We're not doing the aquatic side of things. So when you see the word aquatic, it's pretty safe to, I think, to ignore that. This exercise program has shown in research to be effective at managing pain and stiffness of arthritis while improving strength, weight-bearing, flexibility, range of motion, and relaxation techniques. The steps to getting certified are you would register online, and I'm going to take you to the website in a minute. You read the manual, you take the course, you complete the exam, you provide proof of current CPR, and then you begin leading classes in your community. To renew your certification and to stay current, you need to renew every 2 years. So let's take a look at the website. You'll navigate across the top here to AF Program, and here you have three choices. Let's start with the first one. And here you see all the steps we just talked about. When you get ready to start the course, you'll hit here. This will take you to a button. You'll hit this, and then you will need to create an account. And from there, you'll be taken to another site where you will put in a code to start the exam. This code will be provided to you beforehand. Arthritis program links and downloads here. Here are many links to the forms, the surveys, the things that you will be using throughout your certification as you provide arthritis exercise in your community. I don't want to take our time right now to go through that. Leader tools. Here you can sign up for monthly newsletters, ideas for warm-ups and cool-downs, ways to motivate audiences, fun activities. And if you are interested, you would click there to sign up. You'll see Julia at aeawave.com. Julia will be your contact person. She and I have talked many times. Her name is Julia Sullivan, and I found her to be very, very helpful. Walk with Ease. This program is Arthritis Foundation's walking program. It's a signature program. It's based in the community on physical activity and self-management of arthritis. There's a downloadable app for an iPhone, an iPad, and any Android device. Walk with Ease education promotes successful physical activity for people with arthritis, self-management to walking safely and comfortably, and exploring other exercise and self-management programs to deliver benefits. And while walking is central activity, it also focuses on health education, strengthening and stretching, motivational strategies. As a leader, you'll help build participant confidence by putting together personal and group walking plans with realistic goals and tips. You'll receive Arthritis Foundation certification, a leader manual with exercise illustrations, health education information, and a 6-week walking plan. Walk with Ease can be done by individuals or by groups led by trained leaders. It provides step-by-step instruction for forming these groups in your area. Materials such as pedometers, walking diaries, and workbook guides are available to you and made possible by Oklahoma AgriBility. This is a great program to consider to offer to OHCE members, for example. A session includes socialization time, a pre-walk mini lecture, warm-up and cool-downs, and a 10 to 35-minute walking period. You would start very slow in the beginning and walk gradually at greater distances. Arthritis Foundation has outsourced Walk with Ease training to AFAA, Aerobics and Fitness Association of America. Let's take a look at their website. So here's our homepage. We would hit under courses, and we would look for continuing education along this banner line. And there is Arthritis Foundation Walk with Ease, a nice explanation with more information. To enroll, you would go over here, and as with the other training, the arthritis exercise program training, you would put in a code prearranged that would allow you to go through the training and be paid for with this code. Walk with Ease is an evidence-based program that's been proven to help people with arthritis and related conditions by reducing pain, increasing balance, strength, and walking pace while improving overall health. Tai Chi, an ancient form of movement, has been shown in research studies to impact a person's balance, helping to combat against falls and other issues of strength. It consists of different poses, or forms as they're called, that are combined to be performed in a slow, continuous, circular, and flowing manner. It can be beautiful to watch, and it can look deceptively simple. And just know that doing Tai Chi consistently promotes balance, strength, mobility, confidence, and task. And when you're doing this training, you will teach 8 forms or movements to use in at least 12 weeks of practice. Research shows that it helps with balance, but it also helps reducing blood pressure, builds strength, and particularly in our core or middle region of the body. It improves sleep and reduces depression. Oklahoma Department of Health's Injury Prevention Service offers Tai Chi leader programming, an excellent exercise for strength and balance, and it's free of charge. This is a rather long link, but you can see it takes you to this page. On the previous slide, I have different steps of getting you here, but you'll notice over here there's a link for classes, instructor classes. I invite you to take a look at this website for more information. AVY is our contact at the health department. She can be contacted by email that you see here for any questions that you might have. Now let's turn our attention to assistive technology, the other resource that this program has to offer. I think it's helpful to briefly review some official definitions when we are talking about Ag4Life Oklahoma Strong Programming. Here we define the term disability as an inability or a restricted ability to perform actions related to all manner of things, self-care, home care, work, community, leisure roles, all in their cultural context and physical environment. And yes, it's important to have an official definition to protect the civil and legal rights of individuals. But I think it's also important for us to focus on the word restricted here, as we may be quick to dismiss a disability as someone using a wheelchair or having an amputation. But we see disability is much broader than that. If you'll recall, arthritis, according to the Arthritis Foundation, is our number one disability affecting 50 million plus Americans. AT, assistive technology, is anything really that safely and efficiently helps us to increase, maintain, or improve functioning. That's fairly broad. And when we think of the phrase individual's disabilities here at the end of the definition, we'll recall from the previous slide that disability is about both inability or restricted ability to perform desired tasks, actions, and activities. Again, AT must be officially defined to ensure individuals with disabilities get the resources they need. And something else to consider. The need for various types of AT may change as folks get stronger or more mobile. But for those of us who might use some of these tools and devices to keep doing things safely, keep using your AT. Let's look at some of the AT resources you have available for class demonstration. Here on the left, these shovels are called her shovels and are crafted specifically and scientifically for women. They call it hergonomics. These tools are designed with ergonomics in mind so that you'll find maximum comfort, greater efficiency, and safety and ease of use are priority. This makes tools look like these to be easiest, safest, most comfortable, and most effective tool you can use. For example, every feature of her shovel is based on a woman's body and their particular shoveling and digging styles. From the shape and the diameter of the handle to the enlarged step on the tempered steel blade, this shovel is developed to maximize the female form. The one-handed hammer and the D-grip that are already in your FCS AT inventory show how you can use AT to improve grip, strength, and dexterity. And look for Arthritis Foundation's seal of approval on select AT resources. As you know, we're fortunate to have ready access to great AT resource experts. Oklahoma Able Tech and OCAT here on Stanley-Warner campus. Oklahoma Department of Rehabilitation is there for those who want to stay gainfully employed. And if you want AT information as it might apply in an ag setting, bookmark National Agribility's Breaking New Ground program at Purdue. I want to take just a minute and run through a couple of these and show you. Here's Oklahoma Able Tech, and you can see from that website a wealth of information how to borrow a device or get help funding a device. If you need medical equipment for free, they have a lending or they have an eBay library, but it's for free. If you'd like to donate a device, so come back to this website and take a look at what they offer. The other website I wanted you to look at is the National Agribility website. From here, you can see they have a wealth of database tools and resources. They give you communities of interest if you're interested in that, online training, really a wealth of information as it applies to agribility projects working with folks in agriculture. The resource magazine, Ag4Life, Keeping Oklahomans Strong, was distributed to you last year and made possible by Oklahoma Agribility. As I mentioned in an earlier video, please be judicious in handing them out, as they're intended to be used as a workbook for any series of lessons you might teach. You'll find healthy aging tips, work pages for families, and a wealth of resource contact information. We hope the success stories of Oklahoma farm and ranch families who used Agribility services will inspire your audiences to reach out to Oklahoma Able Tech and other AT organizations listed on the previous slide. Ag4Life works to help audiences find, use, and enjoy AT. And Oklahoma Agribility has added to your county AT library with sparkling new tools and devices to promote safety, efficiency, and satisfaction in your audiences. Agribility also provide the FCS at-a-glance AT inventory pictured here, along with the resource magazine we just talked about. This inventory will help you choose what AT devices you might feature in your lessons, as they're listed by conditions they help, giving vendor information for interested audience members. It's my hope that many of you will write for additional funds to keep your AT inventory fresh and informing. The FCS Ambassador Awards provide many opportunities to do just that. Using funds to help audiences remain active physically and mentally is the very reason these awards exist. As we close, I come back to this slide because I think it best captures what we hope to accomplish with Ag4Life Oklahoma Strong programming. We want to adopt an Ag4Life style while teaching audiences of all ages how to age well for life. In arthritis management programming, Amp It Up, we're giving our audiences the tools to effectively manage their arthritis pain and stiffness using targeted exercise and appropriate AT resources. I do encourage you to become a certified leader of effective arthritis management exercise. The added benefit of 3 different classes for folks to attend ensures FCS acknowledgement across the state. I'm confident you will help Oklahomans control their arthritis. Gina Peek, your housing specialist, will lead Ag4Life activities. I know you will all work together to help Oklahomans stay in their personal best shape, taking control of their arthritis, using the knowledge and the expertise that FCS provides. As I've said before, you as an educator are positioned to make a difference in your community by helping audiences recognize their agricultural heritage and adopt an Ag4Life style to stay Oklahoma strong. Thank you for listening today, and my very best to you all.